Hi, this is Professor Sean Foster, and this is a quick video on how to make prefab objects inside of UDK. In addition to that, I'm going to show how to integrate a Kismet sequence that you want to make part of the prefab object. Now, prefabs are a great way to add repetition and also build objects in ways that achieve a modular design concept inside of UDK. So it's a really key skill to know how to do. So let's get going and into the tech demo. All right, so basically what I've done is I've copied two assets from the UDK cool building meshes collection into my own package. I've also created a trigger and I've brought in a particle system. The idea is that I want to design a game that has a whole bunch of objects that look exactly like this, and when the player walks in, they get points for sort of collecting these visual hotspots. You can see there's the particle system. So right now we walk up to it and you say it's got it, and we want to set it up so that you get points every time. And we also want to develop this so we could just drag this whole system in, including the particle system and the trigger, and that you'd get points every time and those points would add all up. So how do you do that? You do that using prefabs. Now, if you just want to make a prefab collection of geometry, you could sort of go through and control click all of these pieces and right click and say make prefab. But we're going to take this one step further and we want to integrate the Kismet sequence. So we need to do a few things for that first. So I've created the trigger already. When it's touched, it goes to the emitter. And then I've also sort of got ready for the next step, which is I want to give the user points every time they trigger something. So how do I do this? Well, I want to do a remote trigger and add the points. I mean, you might be saying, why can't I just sort of connect here? And that's because in order for UDK to add this into a prefab, you need to so I'm going to do a marquee around this whole object. So Control and Alt, right click, and I'm going to say make new sequence. We'll call this points for player. And now it's a new sequence object. And now we want the sequence to talk to this point system. So in order to do that, I'm going to right click and say new action, event, activate remote event. And in the remote event tab here, so I'm going to say new event, remote event. So you need a name for your remote event. We'll call this points. So now we get to go in here, hook that up, call this points also, the event name. There we go, we've got a green light, and so this should trigger points every time we touch it. Let's just give it a try to make sure this works. Got it. And we want to output a result so that we can make sure that we're getting our points. So I'm going to add a log here, L and click. And I also want to show off the float result here. Or I could show off the int result. But and then I'm going to expose, right click, expose variable. I want to expose the integer, actually the float. And let's see, we should have 10 points when we click on that. Yep, great. Okay, so now let's create our Kismet. Let's create our prefab. So I'm going to click all of the objects that need to be into the prefab. Looks like there's one more. Great. Right click, create prefab. I'm going to put into my package called my prefab demo. I'm going to put that in a group called prefabs. And if everything goes well, it will find the Kismet sequence called points for player that I gave it. And it'll say, is that correct? Say yes. And it says, do you want to replace these actors with an instance of the new prefab? Sure. So now we've got, if we take a look at this, a prefab object. So let's drag a few more point huts in there. And you can see now we've got this prefab object inside of my content browser package. So now, if I want, I can create additional. Object. But at any rate, this should work. And got 10 points, 20 points, 30 points for the win. All right, so we've done it. We've created prefabs and a Kismet sequence that will work with them. So thanks so much for watching.